Alright, so welcome to my review for X-Men Dark Phoenix, or Dark Phoenix, it doesn't really matter what it's titled, it's still Dark Phoenix, and this is the second incarnation of the Dark Phoenix saga, which was originally adapted in the third X-Men film, The Last Stand, and I didn't really like that one too much, but this one I did like, it's considerably better, more than that one, which is interesting because I have heard so much shit about this movie. So many people have been shitting all over this movie, and I personally don't understand it. I actually really like this movie. So I'm just gonna quickly get into my likes, dislikes. With this movie, what I liked about it is how it set up, how it essentially started and set up Jean Grey and her story and everything, which is not too much of a surprise because they did that with the last one. It's just, there was so much shit going on in that movie that they had like 5 different introduction scenes. This one just starts out with Jean Grey as a young girl, just that, and then we move on to this awesome mission sequence. Like, if you've seen the trailers or if you know the comic book, then you'll know what the mission is. And with that mission sequence, I did like it because it was like, yes, this is the X-Men that we haven't seen these X-Men in a while. We haven't seen an X-Men team like this in a long time where they're a team, where they're efficient, where they're getting shit done. Like, I love that shit. That, we haven't seen X-Men like this in a while. Also, the action in this movie is good. I like the action. There's not that much of it though. And I'll get into that right now. There wasn't that much action in this movie. That for me could have been a problem, but it wasn't, because when the action scenes happened, I really liked them. Okay, the action scenes I thought were well filmed, performed and everything. I liked the action. Alright, I have a lot to say with this movie, but when it comes to my positives, that's where they end, okay? I do have one huge negative with this movie, and it's just one line that was said in the movie by Jennifer Lawrence, right? You know what? All the women save the men around here. Maybe it should be called X-Women. Nah. And the other thing that I didn't really hate, because I hated that line, but the other thing that I was not sure about was the whole vilifying Professor X in this movie, because the choices he made in the past that affect events in this movie, I was just thinking, like, would he actually do that? I don't know if he would. Like, the choices that he made in The Last Stand, in that incarnation of Dark Phoenix, made sense, but in this one, I don't know if Professor X would make those decisions. But did I like the movie? Yes, I really liked the movie. As I said, the action was good. I love all the seeing the characters come back and seeing them work more efficiently this time as the X-Men team. And I loved all of that shit. Also, I was gonna say this, and I'm gonna say this now. Sophie Turner, that plays Jean Grey in this movie, so good. I did not realize how good of an actress she really is. I thought of it like this. Like, this movie is really just her. Like, we're following her, right? And if not for her, Sophie Turner's good performance, the movie then for me would have gotten boring, okay? But for me, it really wasn't that boring. Like, there were some boring parts in it, but whenever it was focusing on Sophie Turner's Jean Grey, I was just interested. I was interested to see what would happen and to see the actions that she makes and how that would affect the other X-Men or the other mutants like Eric or whatever. That stuff really interested me. And why wouldn't it? Because I've been watching characters since First Class, and by these characters I mean these characters portrayed by Michael Fassbender and James McAvoy and Nicholas Holt and Jennifer Lawrence and stuff. So why would I not be invested in those scenes, right, where shit goes awry with these characters portrayed by these actors? Why would I not be invested in those scenes? So really quickly, I just want to get this out of the way. As I said earlier in the review also, I like this movie more than The Last Stand. I have said, been pretty vocal on the fact that The Last Stand is one of my, I guess one of my most hated X-Men movies. I hate that movie with a passion. It's so messy. And this is the one complaint that I've heard about this movie as well, that this one is also messy. I don't understand that. I'll give an example as to why I'm confused. With The Last Stand, right? That one, I thought, was actually genuinely messy because it had so many plot lines and side stories going on at the same time in the same movie. It didn't... a lot of stuff didn't need to happen in that movie. For example, you've got the Jean Grey stuff, which is meant to be, center focus of that movie, but then there's also a kid with a cure who can, like, this kid has a mutant power to cure other mutants, and then, Eric is planning to invade or take over or whatever the shit he was planning in that movie, and then there's also Angel, who is in the movie. I mean, the movie also starts out with him, right? He has an intro. One of the first scenes in the movie is with him as a kid, but then they barely use him in that movie. It was a bit hard to follow and very, I wouldn't say boring, but it was very, messy, which is why I don't understand why people are saying that this movie is messy, Dark Phoenix, because as far as I could tell, there are only two plot lines going on. The one with Jean Grey, right? And that's pretty much the whole movie, but then there's also like a side plot line or side story where she had aliens influencing her to gain something of their own, right? But that's it. That's two. Last Stand had more than two. It had like five. This movie, I thought, personally, I liked because it only had two that were very simple and straightforward, and from there we could just follow Jean Grey. You know, in basically this movie is all about Jean Grey. This movie focuses more on Jean Grey than The Last Stand did, right? And that's what I wanted to see, and I got that. And on top of that, it had some really cool action. So I don't understand the hate that this movie is getting. I'm probably the one human being on planet Earth that actually likes this movie. Anyway, that's my review for X-Men Dark Phoenix. I think, yeah, this is the last X-Men film in this franchise, so that's good. I guess I'll see you in my review for what's the other one? The New Mutants. I think that's the other one. Anyway, I will see you in that review.